Can the fire pump and jockey pump sensing lines be installed in series? Can we tap the sensing lines above the alarm check valve? And why do we need inverted check valves with drilled holes in them? We will answer these questions in this video as we give a comprehensive summary of all the fire pump sensing line requirements. What is a fire pump sensing line? The fire pump sensing line is a mechanical piping system that enables the fire and jockey pump controllers to monitor system pressure variations. These controllers send signals to their respective pumps to run or stop when the system pressure reaches their cut-in or cut-out pressure. This allows the fire pump to run automatically when a fire occurs. Why do fire and jockey pump controllers need to monitor pressure? To understand why these controllers need to monitor pressure, we need to know first the intended function of each pump. Fire pumps are designed to deliver large amounts of water for fire suppression. Jockey pumps maintain system pressure by replenishing normal water loss, not to suppress fire. When an automatic fire sprinkler head activates during a fire, water immediately comes out from the piping because it is normally pressurized. The fire pump controller will read this sudden drop in water pressure and send the signal for the pump to run, delivering large amounts of water to achieve fire suppression. The same thing will happen if a trained operator or firefighter opens a fire hose valve connection. If the water loss is insignificant, such as minimal leakage along the system, the fire pump controller will ignore this pressure drop, technically because it will not reach its cut-in pressure. Instead, the jockey pump controller, which is programmed to run first, will activate the jockey pump to replenish the system pressure back to normal. What should be the pressure settings of the fire pump and jockey pump? The jockey pump cutout pressure, or the system's maintaining pressure, should be equal to the fire pump churn or maximum pressure. The jockey pump cut-in pressure should be 10 psi lower than its cutout. On the other hand, the fire pump cut-in must be 5 psi lower than the jockey pump cut-in. The fire pump should not have a cutout pressure because it's supposed to be manually turned off. For multiple fire pumps, the cut-in pressure of the second fire pump must be 5 psi lower than the first one configured to run first. Here's an example of a fire pump setting. Consider a 1000 GPM pump with the churn rating of 115 psi connected to a cistern tank. Note that these pressure settings are NFPA recommendations and not mandatory. It is best to follow these recommendations because the system maintaining pressure setting should be close to the fire pump's maximum pressure or churn. This can avoid sudden surge when the fire pump activates, thus preventing water hammer. However, in some cases, slight deviation may be permitted depending on engineering judgment. Can the sensing line for a fire pump and jockey pump be combined and installed in series? The fire pump and jockey pump sensing lines cannot be combined and installed as a single pipe. Each controller shall have its own individual pressure sensing line. Can the fire pump sensing lines be tapped above the alarm check valve? No, this typical mistake can make the weekly churn test difficult. The operator would have to drain significant water from the system to simulate a pressure drop during weekly test. This repeated draining and refilling of water not only disturbs the system, but also introduces new oxygen to the piping, which speeds up internal corrosion, especially for systems without automatic air vents. Where should the sensing lines be connected? The pressure sensing line connection for each pump, including jockey pumps, shall be tapped between the pump's discharge check valve and discharge isolation valve. What piping material and size should be used in installing pressure sensing lines? The piping size shall be 1/2 inch nominal. The material shall be brass, copper pipes type K, L, or M, or series 300 stainless steel pipe. Soft copper tubing is not permitted. Can there be a shut off valve in pressure sensing lines? There shall be no shut off valve in the fire pump sensing line as it can hinder the pump's performance in monitoring pressure variations when left in the closed position. This might render the system inoperable during a fire. Why do I need inverted check valves with holes in them? The inverted check valves act as a pressure snubbers. Two bronze or stainless steel check valves shall be installed in each pressure sensing line, spaced at least 5 feet apart, with a nominal 2.4 mm hole drilled in the clapper to serve as dampening. This enables the pump controllers to monitor sudden pressure drops while dampening the effect of sudden pressure increases to protect the pressure transducers. The pressure transducers are very sensitive electronic devices inside the controllers. What are the components of the sensing line test assembly? The sensing line test assembly shall consist of two inspection test valves attached to the pressure sensing line, which shall consist of a T, a valve, and a second T with the branch plug, which serves as a provision for a gauge and the second valve. Its function is to simulate pressure drop during weekly churn tests and annual performance testing.
So what are the three benefits of installing the sensing line properly? Installing sensing lines correctly can provide many advantages. First, it can help us with our weekly churn test, which includes simulating a pressure drop to test the automatic function of our fire pump. We can do this using the test valve assembly. You will not need to outsource every single fire pump churn test because it becomes so much easier.
It protects the fire and jockey pump controller's electronic transducers, which are sensitive and expensive components, from pressure surges by using the pressure snubbers. It extends the life of the fire and jockey pump controller by using piping that is not susceptible to corrosion, such as stainless steel. Fire pump systems monitor pressure changes using pressure sensing lines so that they can run automatically during a fire. Each pump needs its own pressure sensing line, which shall not be connected in series. There shall be no shut-off valve along the pressure sensing line. The connection for each pump shall be tapped between the pump's discharge check valve and discharge isolation valve. Piping size shall be 1/2 inch nominal, and the material shall be brass, rigid copper pipes types KLRM or series 300 stainless steel pipe or tube. If you want to learn how to conduct a fire pump churn test, we made a video that outlines the requirements in three simple steps.